All right, this is going to be a completely random episode and not part of my normal C++ weekly lineup. So, this is a special edition thing. I just wanted to share with you all my small collection of devices that run Python interpreters. And these all use MicroPython and/or CircuitPython. So hopefully, it'll be fun. Okay, so of course I have to point out that you need to check out the video description and buy some of my C++ books and support the channel, Patreon, subscribe, do all the things. There's lots of cool stuff linked in every video description about upcoming events. I am going to be doing some C++ training, hopefully at CVPCon coming up in October, as well as NDAC Tech Town in September. So make sure you check those things out. Okay, so the first thing that I'm going to cover is this Adafruit macro pad here. I don't currently have it plugged in. I am reluctant to plug it into the laptop that I'm currently recording from because this is a acts as a keyboard and or mouse. It has all the capability of doing that. You plug it in, it can be any device that you want it to be. It's got the 12-key keypad here, a nice little OLED screen, a multi-position thing, and you might see this Stemma QT right here. This is using it's a I squared C bus interface that lots of devices support now, where you can have just these little connectors and daisy chain these all up and have lots of different sensors and inputs and outputs and things that you might want to talk to over I squared C while you're doing your Python device programming. It's a great way for learning embedded stuff and using Python at the same time. So this is the MS8607 pressure, humidity, and temperature sensor, and this has support built right into it in Adafruit's Python CircuitPython libraries. So you can easily go and download those libraries, get all kinds of device support for I2C devices specifically. It's awesome. Now, I actually use this device every time I'm editing because I have keyboard shortcuts set up for the video editor that I'm using, and I have this little widget hanging off of it here just for the fun of it to tell me what the current temperature sensor, pressure, humidity, all that stuff is. Now, the next device I'm going to point out is the BBC Microbit. And this has a grid of LEDs here with a surprising number of sensors. It has one of those 9-axis accelerometer, magnometer, compass things built into it, as well as a little speaker, and it's got Bluetooth, and you can do all kinds of things with this. Now, closely related to it is this somewhat knockoff Pico ad here. So this one has fewer sensors built into it than the BBC Microbit, but a much larger grid of LEDs. Now I'm going to go ahead and plug this one in, and we can actually see what it looks like to edit and work on this environment. I just have to make sure I have an appropriate cable nearby. Yeah, this device is the one that I have most set up at the moment to demonstrate how all of these things work together in the CircuitPython ecosystem. Now, see this JSON Turner here? That's awfully fun, right? Okay, so this is actually the Python code that's currently running on this thing. So it's so super straightforward. I'm just going to go ahead and delete that and notice this display clear. Now it is, I don't know what that comment is. It was in the example code. It imports a few different Python libraries, and it might be difficult to read that JSON was here. Like, we actually want some shadow on it or something at the moment. But I'm just doing a clear, and then I am doing the scroll. Now, again, this is imported. This is their sample stuff. So I can actually go ahead and delete a couple of these things that I don't need. Now, I can update this and say, Welcome. Welcome C++ Weekly Fans. Set the brightness to higher. That value is up to like 255. These LEDs can actually get crazy bright. Let's just go ahead and do that. Let's do a really bright one. And then as soon as I save, you'll notice that the device is rebooting, restarting, and now it is displaying exactly what I asked it to at the brightness that I asked it to display at. This is so crazy easy to be able to familiarize yourself with some embedded development, some hardware stuff. If you were so inclined, you can also hook up I2C sensors and stuff to this with these pinouts. Which brings me to the next part of this particular ecosystem that I find interesting. So first of all, the PicoEd here is a little bit easier to get than the Microbit, depending on supply chain at the moment, but they both have the same pin compatible thing here. So now there's an entire ecosystem with this. I can plug this in here and I can use an external power supply, program the USB, access all of the pins on the microcontroller that's on this thing, which just for the record is the Raspberry Pi 2040 on the PicoEd. And on the topic of there being an entire ecosystem around them, you may have noticed this one has a piggyback screwed onto it, and this gives me AAA batteries that I can power this from, and like basically lanyard holder. Might be fun to use at a conference or something. So there's this also piece of hardware, and similarly, I can bolt it on to the Microbit. This is an aftermarket thing, and I still have access to the buttons on the front and all the sensors and everything, of course. But this one powers it with 2 3-volt cell batteries, lithium batteries, and so that could have its own interesting applications as well. This breakout board is interesting. I want that because I want to play with having my Microbit also be able to have full access to all of my collection of I2C devices. If you've been a long-term viewer of this channel, then you've probably seen some of my earlier stuff with using a Raspberry Pi running full Linux and accessing I2C devices from there. For all of these devices, it really is very easy to just go in here. You open up this Python file. Notice it actually says on drive D. It's the drive that this device presents itself as when you plug it in. It just shows up as a drive, and you edit the files, save them, it automatically reloads and runs the code. And it is worth pointing out that you can, of course, program these things with C and C++ if you want to. You just need an appropriate ARM compiler. I haven't really played with that. I've only been playing with this. And any libraries that you want access to are going to be in this lib folder. And you can see it has these Adafruit things already copied on here. And if you go to the CircuitPython website, then you can download updates for all these devices, plug them in, whatever. All right, so that is 3 devices that just show up as drives when you plug them in and are running Python pretty much by default. Now, of course, I don't really need to introduce these things because I've already shown them on the channel, but just a reminder that we do have entire series of calculators that run Python and have MicroPython built into them already. This one, the NumWorks, is basically designed around Python and has, well, it's very tiny to see on the screen. The Casio in many ways is still my favorite. It's very difficult to program on, but I find like in a fun way because it's so much more limited when you have this inexpensive black and white Casio with Python. And the TI-83, it's fine. I'm looking forward to better accessibility of getting TI calculator devices with Python built in and not having to buy the special Python edition ones. So yeah, there you have it. That's my current collection of devices that can just run Python and could be great fun learning tools if you've got friends, family members who are interested in learning to program. I'm not entirely sure if I'd recommend the MacroPad first because it has so many inputs and outputs, and you can easily connect I2C devices to it. And it has the OLED screen, and it can behave as a keyboard and a mouse, and it can do all the things with your computer. Or if I might be more inclined to the Pico Ed with this awesome, relatively high resolution LED grid display thing going on here. Now, I haven't tried this, but since both the Microbit and the Pico Ed also act as USB devices when you plug them in, probably can also load those personalities so that they act as USB keyboard mouse, if you are so inclined. And then that would open up some interesting possibilities if you just wanted a tiny, tiny keyboard here, if you will, with a tiny grid display on it, or perhaps use it as an air mouse. So as you rotate the thing and it uses its gyroscope, that could be fun. All ideas to play with, all pretty accessible. And I did definitely leave out one other detail, and that is the fact that lots of these projects, particularly the Microbit, you can actually code everything online on a website, and you get a web browser that lets you simulate and step through the things on the device. And that is with Microsoft Make Code. And when you plug your device in, it can actually just show up here. One of the important things to note is that you do actually need a web browser that knows how to talk the web USB protocol. Let's see if we can connect device or not. Yes, the device is connected. And so I have to allow it access to the device. And interestingly, you can program this thing in JavaScript or Python and do the simulation, do the connection to it, and upload the code to the actual device and run it. So, all really cool ecosystem as well. All right, I'm going to stop here. Thanks for watching this random episode. I hope you found it interesting. Yes, I am having a lot of fun playing with Python-enabled embedded devices. Don't be surprised if I have a little bit more content about that on the channel, but at the moment I am not planning to disrupt the normally scheduled C++ weekly stuff, so you'll still have to subscribe to my Python playlist at the very least if you're interested in more content about microcontroller programming with Python and getting started with programming with Python. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe.